Hello makers, I want to learn to program Python so I can program these Raspberry Picos. I could install something on my PC, but since this one is made by Raspberry, I thought it would be nice to program this via a Raspberry Pi computer. I want to make it close to a desktop PC, so I found this cool case, the Argon One M.2. What makes this case so unique and expensive is it has an adapter for SSD drives. So I bought the cheapest SSD drive, which is compatible to this case. It's a Kingston A400. I'm not sponsored by Argon, Kingston, or Raspberry Pi, or any other company. And I'm trying to make a little PC out of it. In order to install Raspbian on this hard drive, I need an adapter from M2 SSD to USB 3, which I have here. The other option would be to flash the Raspberry Pi with a new firmware so it can install the Raspbian over network. I think I will go with this solution. So I bought this without purpose. It's not suitable for children below the age of 8. What the heck? Has an aluminium case which distributes the heat of the Raspberry Pi evenly over the case. On the top it has a passive cooler. These are for the CPU and RAM chip, I guess, and an active fan, which can be automatically controlled via Raspbian. And an infrared receiver. So there must be a remote control for this. Interesting. This is an adapter plate. A lot of screws, heat pads, and the adapter to connect this board, which is the adapter board for the SSD drive, to a USB 3 port. This is done externally. We have here the Raspberry Pi 4 with 4 GB. And let's start by flashing a new firmware so that we can install Raspbian directly on our SSD drive. Now we put the cards into the Raspberry Pi. Add a power supply. And to check when the firmware update is done, we also attached a monitor. So we start our Pi. And as soon as the green LED starts flashing, which would take seconds, and you see a green screen on your monitor, that means the flashing process should be complete. When you can see this green screen on your monitor, now we can remove the SD card and we can assemble our setup. Let's start by adding the SSD drive By the time filming this, you couldn't add any SSD card, which I learned from other YouTubers. In the channel Explaining Computers and Jeff Geeling, both used the Kingston A400 drive, and it worked. Let's see if it does a trick. I'm using the 120GB because it was the cheapest and smallest. Be honest, as a Linux desktop PC, this would be too much anyways. It's very important to use those thermal heat pads, otherwise the gap between the heatsink and the CPU would be too high and it wouldn't be cooling effectively. So let's peel this off. Size, so one on the CPU, one on the memory chip. And before we put this into this case, we should attach the daughter board. Little fiddling here around. Yep, this seemed to work. And hopefully this will... What's with the spring? Line up with a pin header. Adding some screws, but beware not to use the four outer screws, otherwise you cannot screw the bottom of it. Got one left. Probably a spare. Let's put on the rubber feet. And attach the USB 3 connector. And you still have access to the USB 3 port. Let's try this by attaching a random cable. Isn't perfect, but it still fits. Shouldn't be, the cable or device shouldn't be thicker than this, otherwise it won't fit. Couldn't they done it smaller? Probably. Let's attach it to a monitor and see if we can upload a new Raspberry version directly to the SSD card. So after several restarts and failures, I managed to get to this Raspberry Pi boot screen. It's a Raspberry Pi imager, as you know it from your desktop. We are choosing, first of all, we are choosing the right keyboard. I have a German keyboard, DE. But I want the operating system to be English. Now I'm choosing an operating system. Let's see, we are using Raspbian. Drumroll. Yeah, this is our SSD drive. choose this and hit write. During this install, the operating system is downloaded and written on the storage on the fly. Well, after several reboots, we've installed Raspberry Pi directly to our SSD card. Well, we have set up everything and we are ready to program with Python. So let's talk about the pros and cons of this case. One big pro is the design. I really like the design. This big space here really demands on putting a sticker on it, which I kind of like. The aluminium case is a heatsink itself and has a built-in fan that is automatically controllable via a custom software. Well, I don't know why I have a spring and a screw lift after installing everything. Maybe I should have read the manual, but I never read manual, so I probably put it in the spare parts bin. Something I really like is that the hard drive isn't external anymore, but hidden within the case. And it has full HDMI ports now. There's also a magnetically fixed cover with all the GPIO pins. For my purposes, this is very convenient. I want to learn programming with Python and using also the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi. But if you're buying a case where you can put in a hard drive, you probably will use it as a server. So exposing the GPIO pins is a nice feature, but in most cases you probably won't use this. And the big disadvantage is the price. I paid about 55 euros for it and an additional of 25 euros for the hard drive, which is a total cost of about 80 euros. For this price, you could get a Raspberry Pi 4 with 8 gigabytes of RAM, if you could get hold of one. But my problem is, I've never seen another case with a built-in SSD controller. So this is by now the perfect case for a Raspberry Pi server. I think about upgrading my Home Assistant server. I would like to have another of this one as a file server. What do you think of this? Is it really worth the money? Have you seen another case with a built-in SSD controller? Let me hear about in the comments what do you think about it. And until then, be creative and bye.